Okay, thank you, Mr. Chairman, for introduction. I would like to present some few data concerning the supplementation of the selenium. The aim of the study was evaluation of the influence of vitamin E and selenium supplementation on several biochemical parameters in dairy cows during transition period. As you know, transition period is the most important period in the life of a dairy cow. It takes from 3 weeks postpartum, prepartum, to 3 weeks postpartum. Cows during this period can have several metabolic changes, like including excessive production of free radicals that contributes to oxidative stress and directly impairs immune function. Selenium, as you know, is a very important trace element. In our country, we noticed a few areas deficient in this element, and selenium can inhibit glycolysis, protects the body against the toxic effects of cadmium, boosts humoral and cellular immunity, and contributes to the maintenance of vascular homeostasis under exposure to pro-oxidative stressors. What about vitamin E? It's a very vital role in living organisms. Vitamin E, probably the most important antioxidant in cell membranes, protects polyunsaturated fatty acids against oxidation and boosts immune system as well. Here, material and methods. We made this examination on 20 animals divided into groups. 10 animals was the experimental group, 10 animals was the control group. We give to the experimental group 5 days prepartum vitamin E and selenium, 30 milliliters intramuscularly. Composition of this treatment was tocopherol acetate 50 milligrams, sodium selenite, and 0.5 milligram of sodium selenite. It was done on pregnant Holstein Friesian cows during third lactation. It was fed by TMR and read in freestyle system in the same barn. BCS of these cows was 4 to 44.2. And control group didn't receive any supplementation. We collect blood sample 5 days prepartum, and the day of parturition, 5 days postpartum, and 10 days and 15 days postpartum. In collected blood, we estimate few parameters like concentration of selenium and vitamin E, activity of glutathione peroxidase, activity of aminotransferase, and activity of gamma-glutamyl transpeptidase, and concentration of glucose, cholesterol, triglycerides, non-esterified fatty acid, NIFA, and beta-hydroxybutyrate. And here you can see results. In the experimental group, on the days on the day of parturition, the level of selenium was the highest and was rather stable until the end of experiment, and was higher in whole during whole experiment than the in control group. Concerning vitamin E, you can see that the highest level of the vitamin was observed 5 days after parturition. And peroxidase activity of glutathione peroxidase, it was the highest activity in the end of experiment. We didn't observe any changes between activity of aminotransfer aspartate and gamma-glutamylotranspeptidase. And another result, the concentration of glucose was similar in during entire experiment between the to compare with the control and experimental group. Cholesterol the same. We observed a little bit lower concentration of NIFA in the experimental group and a little bit lower concentration of BHB in experimental group. So, as we observed, selenium and vitamin A concentration were significantly higher in experimental group animals. selenium concentration increased significantly in experimental group, and vitamin E concentration increased significantly in experimental group beginning on 5 days postpartum. The activity of glutathione peroxidase increased significantly in the experimental group, and the highest activity we observed in the last day of experiment. So it means that activity of glutathione peroxidase in red blood cells reflects the long-term selenium status, where selenium level are indicative of rapid and short-lived changes and on its concentration. So conclusions, supplementation with vitamin E and selenium may have a positive impact on the health of the cows during the transition period due to the reduction of the risk of oxidative stress and its associated consequences. And vitamin E levels decrease on successive sampling dates, which indicates that the single dose delivers relatively short-lived effects. For maximum efficacy, vitamin E supplements should be administered in several doses, for example, at weekly intervals, but without the addition of potentially toxic selenium. A single dose of selenium and vitamin E administered 5 days prepartum fulfilled the demand for selenium in high-yielding cows during the transition period. Thank you very much for your attention.